Thanks once more. I have two staunch Kaizer Chiefs supporters. I just want to hear, you know, their comments about tonight's game. Firstly, what's your name, my brother?
Yeah, how's it, man? Mish. My name is Mish. Yebo.
Okay, Mish. You know, thanks very much for joining us on the Kasi Flavor TV.
How's it?
Good, and my brother. What do you think about tonight's game, Celtic and Kaizer Chiefs?
Frustrating. Eh? We played so well in the first half, and then second half we just dropped the ball. Our defense once again let us down. Everything just started so well, and then I don't know what happened. The manager also took, like, I don't know, his changes. Jaya didn't do much. I don't know what he was doing. I don't know. And then again, in the last few minutes, we had like two or three chances we could have taken it, and then we didn't. Castro, I don't know what he's doing there. I'm upset.
Looking at tonight's game and going into the Saturday's game, what do you think? Where can the coach have changes? What do you think should to be done on the day?
Yeah, we need to do something in the back. Eh? The biggest problems you can see they're happening in defense. He needs to sort defense out. I think he needs to drop Cardozo now. He's made too many mistakes, and maybe he should think about bringing back Matoho. Yeah, that's what I think.
It's only defense that you think the coach should look into, or maybe what about the striking force? Are you happy with Piliat and Castro?
I'm happy with Piliat and Castro. Maybe in the last few minutes he should start, like, he started them, and then in the last maybe 15 or 20 minutes bring on Parker or Moon. I think if Parker or Moon were brought him on today, in the last few minutes they would have put those balls in. Yeah.
No, thanks very much for your time. On my left side, I've got another Kaizer Chiefs staunch supporter. Hi, my brother.
How are you, Mr. Machaka?
I'm okay. Thanks very much for joining us as well on Kasi Flavor TV. Your thoughts about tonight's game?
Hey, my brother, I'm very frustrated, honestly speaking. With the games that we're playing, I'm very frustrated. Now we've gone 5 games without a win in the league. So we're starting to be frustrated. I'm frustrated with the whole team of Kaizer Chiefs. We're drawing, we're considering every day, every time. It's a problem. Look, I've got a problem with our defensive, actually. The whole of defense, from this boy, the new boy who's being introduced just now, what's the name, TNT, yeah. And then our right hand side, Mpatlele, he seems to be tired now. And then our Cardoso as well, our Ngezana. Actually, our whole defense is frustrated. Everything is just frustration. Look, even when we come in the middle of the park, second half, Kaizer Chiefs are not playing their normal football. First half, they tried to play everything, but second half, we're not playing our normal football as usual. So I think he should have at least look at our videos, previous Chiefs, how they play. Look at, I will give example with Vladimir Vermezovic. He used to bring, in second half, he used to bring two fresh legs same time. He used to bring 24 and 25, which by the time was David Matebula and Gerrit Skalvik. Look at those boys who are coming and push the team. Now, we have got those two players who can come and make those changes in every second half. We have got Matlasela, we have got the likes of STN. Those guys, if we bring them second half, then they come and change the game. And then the game start to change and then different shape. And then the likes of Bilat is just playing alone there. The likes of Spelele. Look, Katsande is only playing alone at the defensive. I think we need to introduce the second man to come and assist Katsande. Then maybe when we put in the likes of Lebuha Manyama, but still the coach is telling us about saying Manyama is not fit. Put Manyama there. Let him try. Because all the boys, they look frustrated. Bring Khadebe's fresh legs. Mm. Bring Eric Matoho fresh legs. Let them do the job. Mm. Because honestly speaking, it's frustrating, and it's frustrating our coach as well, because look how they introduced our new coach. He was introduced at least a few days before the league can resume. So everything, all blames he put into Patrick Mabedi as it stands. We can't blame Solina as it stands. He doesn't know the boys. He's just trying each and every day. He's putting Jaya. Yes, Jaya is a very good player, but not a good player into Kaizer Chiefs.
While you're still there, do you think Solinas is the right coach for Kaizer Chiefs?
As it stands, I cannot blame Solinas. As it stands, honestly speaking, Solinas is a good coach in the Kaizer Chiefs, but whatever the mistake we did now, it's Patrick Mabedi. Because he's the one that is, I'm very sure he's the one who's controlling everything there. Patrick Mabedi was a defensive, but look how we have got a problem now. We've got a problem in the defensive. But Mabedi, when he plays in Kaizer Chiefs, he was a defender. But then what is that we're doing there? Nothing. Every game we're considering goals. We consider 2 goals on Saturday. We consider 2 goals on Wednesday. What about coming on Saturday? Where's Kune? You can't tell us that Kune is tired and you bring these young boys here.
Kune was injured, I think.
Huh? You put the boys outside and you bring... Machaka is frustrating. I'm very frustrated. Look now, the boys are busy training, but the coach is busy talking about fatigue.
Yeah, we heard the frustration of True Kaizer Chiefs supporters. I'd just like to change the subject a little bit. Guys, can we have just a message for Shaba? What do you say about Shaba?
It's about time, and we've been waiting for him to go play overseas. And we wish him all the best, man. Good luck, brother.
Any message to Shaba?
If there's any player that I know in South Africa who's very humble and disciplined in the field, it's Simphiwe Tshabalala. He's one of the best players in South Africa. Since I've started favoring Kaizer Chiefs, I've never seen Simphiwe getting a red card in the field. So I wish Simphiwe all the best. I mean, let's be fair. Let Simphiwe go and play outside. He has been doing well for Kaizer Chiefs. He has been doing his best. So I still wish Kune as well to go outside and play, because those are the guys who have been with us. They've been faithful to us. They've done all the best. So I wish we should have seen Shaba before he can leave. But all the best to our brother.
You had 2 Kaizer Chiefs supporters wishing Shaba all the best. He has served Kaizer Chiefs, you know, very, very well the past 11 season. And I'm also taking my hat off to Shaba and say, Shaba, all the best, my brother. Thanks very much. You're watching Kasi Flavor TV from FNB Stadium. Kasi for life. Thank you.